Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to cover all the features of the structural member add-in for Fusion 360. The add-in is a productivity tool that enables the user to quickly generate steel frames. First, you have to prepare a skeleton 2D or 3D sketch. After that, insert standard steel shapes by executing the structural member command, which is the primary feature. In the dialog box, starting from top to bottom, you have to select a sketch line or a curve. Specify the name of the frame member. Select the desired standard, the family, the size, the thickness or the weight, the orientation in respect to the sketch entity selected, the rotation, the offset from the x-axis, the offset from the y-axis, and choose the measurement system. Once all the needed members are inserted, you can use the secondary features such as trim extent, miter and notch, also called end treatments, to complete the connection between each member. When you are happy with the result, you have to perform a length update function to change the length value, which will be outdated due to the end treatments that were performed after the insertion. Once the length is updated, the user can publish a cutting list by executing the export to cutting list command. Something worth mentioning is members created by using patterns or mirror features will not be included in the cutting list. I suggest using the copy feature to quickly replicate members for now. Additional features are the ability to edit the library database. The database is inside the resource folder located in the add-in folder. It contains an Excel spreadsheet for each standard. When you open the Excel spreadsheet, you can see a drawing with dimensions for each profile. You can add profiles using the established pattern. You can add new standards by copying one of the existing standards Excel spreadsheet and use it as a template. Populate it with the desired shapes and sizes and save it with a different name. Another additional feature is the import custom shape feature. When you execute that command, you will be prompted to select sketch entities. Make sure you are selecting sketch entities that form a closed profile, otherwise the insertion after that will fail. Assign a name, size and thickness for the custom shape and press OK. The new custom shape is stored in the custom shape spreadsheet and can be inserted the same way you are inserting standard shapes. And as always, thank you for watching.